It's a brick day. No, I'm not bricklaying. I'm a poet, but a bricklay. A bricklay. A brick day, so I'm combining different disciplines. So I'm running for 10 minutes, 20 minutes, sorry. Then I'm cycling for 2 hours. I'm running for 10 minutes. That's the plan. I'm actually on the track in my local park run. Every Saturday morning, 9 o'clock, I used to come to this space, but obviously since COVID, it's been shut down, but it's back open again. But there's no one here, just me. Park run, park runners, get back out there, lace up. Morning, glorious morning, I'm in the forest, doing my second part of my brick session, so I'm on the bike.
Today is all about blue.
Apart from that, I'm going to climb the mountain, the ice cream. To the pinnacle. Two voices, one on my left shoulder, one on my right. The left one saying, you're done. Time to take off the shoes and rest. The right hand voice on my right shoulder saying, pull on your trainers and do 10 minutes. Jogging. That completes the brick session. Which voice will I listen to? You got it. I listen to the voice on the right shoulder, this shoulder, and I'm running. 10 minutes and then the brick is done. The cornerstone will be in place. Not the way my glasses jump to the beat. 1, 2, 3, 4. Brick session complete. So we had 20 minute run, 1.5 hour cycle, followed by a reluctant 10 minute run. Stretching is probably more important than the actual run or the cycle. I often neglect it. I often kind of just squeeze it in at the end. It's for 2 minutes. But I should really take a lot more time to devote to my stretching. Okay.